Unreal Engine 5.6 just dropped with a major update to its game templates. And you'll want to know about this because everything's changed. Whether you're making a shooter, a platformer, or anything in between, there's now a faster way to get started. Templates. Most people treat Unreal templates as disposable, deleting half the content before even hitting play. But in 5.6, these templates are smart, modular, and actually built to help you make real games faster. I've already tested them and built a working prototype using just one of these templates. And in this video, I'll show you what's new, how to get started, and what you need to do to build on top of them. So let's dive in. Before we even get to the variants, Unreal has made big changes to the core templates themselves. They are lighter, faster to download, and come with better performance out of the box. Under the hood, things are far more consistent. The input system now includes a standardized input pack across all templates, complete with mobile support and a widget-based touch thumbstick. You also get better blueprint organization, new interactable elements like jump pads and doors, expanded animation sets, and optimized materials. So instead of starting from scratch or spending time cleaning up bad defaults, you can jump straight into building your game. These aren't just examples anymore. Unreal is clearly treating templates as real building blocks. But that's just the foundation. The real magic in 5.6 is what Unreal did next. Because now, instead of just one template per category, you get multiple pre-built variants tailored for different types of gameplay. Let me show you. In Unreal Engine 5.6, every core game template now comes with variants. Variants are alternate starting points that include the specific mechanics and design setups for different types of gameplay. For example, if you choose the first-person template, you're no longer stuck with just the basic game. You can now choose between Arena Shooter, comes with working AI, pickups, and a UI for ammunition. Survival Horror includes a flashlight system, slower movement, flickering lights, and a more suspenseful atmosphere. The same goes for third person. You've got combat, with melee attacks and enemies already set up. Platformer, with collectibles and jumping logic. Side scroller, with a fixed camera and responsive 2.5D controls. For top down, you can choose between strategy, with click to move controls and unit selection. And twin stick, perfect for arcade style shooters. And for vehicle, you've got off-road, a bouncy terrain reactive setup. Time trial, focused on speed, checkpoints, and lap timing. Each variant is like a mini framework. Smart defaults, ready-to-use blueprints, and solid foundations that you can expand upon right away. What this means is, you don't have to start from zero anymore. Whether you're prototyping an idea, building a game jam project, or starting your next full game, these variants give you a massive head start. You've seen what these variants can do. Now it's your turn. Let me show you exactly how to spin one up so you can stop watching and start creating. Getting started with one of these variants is quick and beginner-friendly. Open Unreal Engine, click on Games as your project category, and pick a core template, like the first person or third person. Once selected, you'll see a drop-down menu labeled Variant. Choose the one that fits your idea, name your project, and click Create. That's it. In seconds, Unreal will generate a fully functional project with everything already wired up. You're not just choosing a template now, you're choosing a direction. And the best part? All the cumbersome setup is already done. You'll enter a project that already feels alive. Working mechanics, clean folders, responsive inputs, and a space for you to build your ideas right away. So instead of wondering where to start, you're already playing, tweaking, and creating within minutes. Now, getting started is just the beginning. The real power of these templates kicks in when you start customizing them, adding your own mechanics, visuals, and ideas on top of what's already there. Let me show you just how far you can push these variants, and how fast you can turn them into something that feels truly yours. Once you've launched a variant, everything you need to expand your game is already in place. Input, animations, even example logic. That means you don't have to figure everything out from scratch. You can build on top of what's already working. Want to swap the character? Just import your mesh and use the existing animation blueprint as a starting point. Need a new weapon or mechanic? You can duplicate the existing blueprints, tweak the logic, and test immediately. Want to change the visuals? Drop in assets from the marketplace or your own library. No need to untangle code or reorganize folders. Everything's modular, labeled, and ready to extend. This is where Unreal's new approach really shines. You're not wasting time setting up input, fixing broken references, or fighting a messy project. You're building your game, fast, clean, and focused on your idea, not boilerplate code. Now, everything I'm showing here, I can do it in minutes. That's because I've been working with Unreal for over 10 years. And that's something a lot of content creators don't always mention. Building fast only works if you've got the foundation. Templates are great for speeding up development, but knowing how to build a game from scratch is what gives you real creative freedom. When you understand how blueprints communicate, how materials are authored, how the gameplay framework works, and how the systems fit together, that's when things really click. You can start learning that for free right here on our YouTube channel. But if you want a faster, more complete path, we build our game development program exactly for that. It's designed to give you the full foundation, step by step, so you can stop second guessing and start creating games with confidence. So that's Unreal Engine 5.6 new approach to templates. And honestly, it's a big shift. You're no longer starting with empty scenes and placeholder logic. You're starting with real systems, clear structure, and a running start. Whether you're prototyping something small or starting your dream project, these new templates give you the momentum to move faster and go farther. If this video helped you, give it a like, subscribe, and let me know in the comments which variant you're diving into first. And if you're serious about making your own game, check out our game development program. It's built to take you from beginner all the way to publishing on Steam. You can even try the finished game from the program on Steam. The link's in the description below. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next one.